There is no better time to be a content creator than just today. Family, I am kind of sort of mind blown. I came home from doing this 3-day conference about leap in the video, helping people jump into a video first content creation sort of workflow. And one of the common questions that came up was, which of the AI platforms should I be using? Is it Claude? Is it ChatGPT? Is it Gemini? And my favorite answer, and I literally just talked about this about 4 times this week, is it doesn't matter. It really doesn't matter. Why? Because these guys constantly leapfrog each other and they're constantly improving. And today, this day right here, right now will be the worst it ever gets because they literally update constantly. Today, I get home, I'm in my computer goofing around, and guess what? Claude Anthropic, AKA Claude, has just dropped Claude Sonnet 4.0, a brand new model. They have 2 versions of this model. There's the Claude Opus model, which is the big thinker, great for coding, doing complex tasks. And then there's Claude Sonnet 4, which is your everyday driver, but also super quick, super smart, can do a lot of intelligent things. Now, the Haiku models, which is their smallest model, still exists, and that's good for just doing quick things. But Claude 4 Sonnet is what we're going to dive into today, because primarily what I use this for is just enhancing my content creation process. So I'm going to just I didn't even mess with it good yet. I'm just going to show you some basic stuff you can do and how I jump into a new model and kind of sort of figure out what's been updated. Now, I did, which got me excited to make this video, is I use Claude to generate YouTube descriptions. And let me tell you why. I realized that other than my buddy Rich, who will call me and let me know I screwed something up, nobody really reads the descriptions unless you tell someone there's a link or something to catch. And even then, they just go see the link and move on. Most people don't read the descriptions. However, there's a new terminology moving around in tech, and that's GEO. It's the modern rendition of SEO. That is those first 5 to 10 AI generated results you get when you search something. And what used to be called the SERP, or search engine results page, is now a list of AI. And on the side, there'll be the sources where the links come from. Normally after that, you'll see the videos. And then after that, you'll get to the standard Google links. So people lying to you about getting you to the top of Google using some SEO are mostly full of shit, because it doesn't work anymore. Everything is about the generated task. So for me, I like to have the AI write a good detailed description, because let's be honest, writing YouTube descriptions is one of the junkiest parts of creating content, and it's easy to get lazy. But you don't have to get lazy, just let the AI write it. And this is one case where I don't even care what the AI writes, as long as it's halfway decent, because that will get you seen on the search page when people are looking for a specific thing. So for instance, my buddy Brandy Joe is getting into the Osmo Pocket 3, and maybe she wants to know what are some of the dope Osmo Pocket 3 accessories. The 10 videos I've made about these things might come up in the Google search because of the way I'm doing my descriptions, and the bots are checking that, because YouTube, Google, same company, they share resources, and if they can keep you in the Google universe, they make more money selling ads. So when your YouTube video is coming from a Google link, and then you get into your YouTube video, and your YouTube video delivers value, entertains, makes someone happy, solve their problems, they watch a bunch more of your videos, you have kept people in the Google shoppingplex for more time. Google rewards you by showing your video to more people because you're being a good citizen of the platform. Long-winded description as to why I do AI descriptions, and I'm going to show you how you can, and it's really simple, but let's jump over to Claude real quick and let's look at some of the stuff that Claude has added into 4.0. Now, this is mostly going to be a blind taste test, but you know what? It's all good. I'm at claude.ai, brand new. Some of the things you could do is click on the plus. You could upload a file, take a screenshot, add things from GitHub, add things from Google Drive, or you can use one of your projects. Now, I do have projects that I use for creating those YouTube video descriptions, but I'll show you how we got there. There is the ability to press learn. So if we click on here, you can generate an educational rubrics, design a learning portfolio, prepare for an exam or an interview, design a learning challenge that pushes my creative boundaries, Compare learning resources, also cool. You can write code. Again, if you're going to write code, I would probably use Opus. That was a little bit better. You have this thing for doing life stuff. So if we press in here, plan some home improvements, develop some self-care practices, handle difficult conversations, create a cleaning routine, create a reading list. Ooh, I like this one. I'm going to go do that one real quick. And then from your various apps, you can create a diplomatic response for a most challenging recent email thread. Give me some tips on how to organize my calendar. Tell me how my project focus has evolved over time. I love having AI critique your work. Very good stuff here. See what emotional themes emerge from my email conversations. Transform my calendar into a fantasy quest journal. These are just some of the cool things that you can do. And over here, you have the ability to select various styles, and you can create new ones, of course. You can extend the thinking model. It makes it work harder on your task. You do have web search turned on, and I do have these other various things put in here. So what we're going to do is generate some ideas for YouTube videos. Now, I use text-to-speech in order to put my prompts in. And for anyone who's new around here, the reason why I do that, number one, I am a horrible typist. I mean, horrible. Arthritis, fat fingers, small keyboard. I'm terrible. The other thing is, I think the reason why you have a hard time writing prompts is it's hard to get your thoughts out into your fingers because there's about a four-step translation from neural to contextual to motor. So I like to speak my prompts in, and then I'm going to show you a trick when you're watching. Anyone who's watching my channel, when you see the secret sauce, let me know. Put an emoji, any emoji you want, into the description, not the description, into the comment section, because I'll know that you know the secret sauce. So let me know. Let's get in. Okay, so here we are at Claude. Now I'm going to use a transcription doohickey because your mans can't type. I want to make some videos for content creators, especially those beginning type content creators who are looking for ways to level up their content creation workflow. Specifically, I want to make the video about how to use Claude's new Sonnet 4 model and help them improve their workflow. First, tell me some of the things that Claude can do to help improve a content creator's workflow, and then generate me a list of content ideas that I could use to make these videos that will help out my fellow content creators. Go ahead and run that. And you can see already it thinks a heck of a lot faster than it did. So it's coming up with the ideas, content planning, script writing, research and fact checking, SEO optimization, repurposing content, analytics performance. It's telling me what these breakdowns all would look like. It's giving me some decent titles, creating, I don't like the word viral. I should tell it that. YouTube thumbnail idea generator, never run out of quick worthy concepts, right? This is just absolutely cool. It's telling me that I could win 4 months of Claude by sharing my invite link. I'll deal with that later. It's like breakthrough creative blocks, AI brainstorming techniques, storytelling frameworks, how to hook your audience every time. Boom, it's giving some really, really cool stuff. Okay, so let's say, place these into a content plan. I would like click worthy titles using one of the 10 most popular marketing frameworks, something that triggers curiosity or some emotion, something that really gets those clicks. Next, for each of the titles, I would like 3 bullet points that I could use as a bullet point script in order to make these videos. And then in the final section, any notes that would be helpful for me as I go to make these videos. Remember that my target audience are mostly beginning content creators who are entrepreneurs, solo entrepreneurs, someone who is looking to start their YouTube content journey. and many of my people are Gen X or Gen X plus. This is why I like to talk to it, because I feel like when you talk to it, your brain just does a much better job of getting what you really want out, as opposed to trying to like think while you type, and then you're like self-editing, and that's why you feel apprehensive about making prompts. I love to talk to it and it works. And yeah, this is just how I do it. So it is coming in, it's telling me about these frameworks. What secrets every successful content creator uses that nobody talks about? How I went from content chaos to 10x output without hiring anyone. These are really good. This content repurposing formula that made me 50,000. Copy this exact process. It's telling me how. The psychology hack that makes TikTok videos go viral. I forgot to tell it that I hate the idea of going viral. Why your YouTube thumbnail sucks. This 5-second fix could double those views. That is definitely a video I would make. You guys know how much I love thumbnails. But look at this. It's just coming up with really cool stuff. And it's like these writings are so much better than they were in the past. They're just coming out really, really good. It's talking about technical considerations. This is really good. Really good. I love it. Create a content calendar. This is why I don't type it, people. With these, this is exactly why I don't type. Boom. Just wanted to show you how sick Claude 4 is. It is quite incredible. Oh my God, this is good stuff. This is good stuff. I could be here all day messing with this. I don't want to be here all day messing with this. So I just wanted to tell you that these are the type of things you can do. Help you with your process. It'll just really get you out there. It's giving you a full breakdown, like a month 3 strategy. Somebody posited to question today in today's work session about getting a template for a content plan. And I was like, fam, somebody else's template is not going to help you. What you can do is just ask your favorite bot to help you generate a content plan. And well, you just saw it right then and there. So I don't want to get too deep, not real tutorial, because listen, I just started messing with Claude 4.0 just now. And already I can see this rabbit hole is going to get deep. When a new model comes out, that is exactly the time to go and bless it. If you're not sure what to ask it, what can it do for you? And then don't forget, it gave us a bunch of examples in the beginning that they set up for you to go and test out. Test them all out. See what's working for you. But definitely go dive into Claude 4.0, whether that's Sonnet or whether that's Opus. Now, you know what I do in all these videos. I always say, I do not know who needed to hear this, but if it was you, write that down in the comment section below. And if you like this video, once again, pop that like button, hit the subscribe button, the notification bell, so you never miss another one of these videos. And right about now, the algorithm will show you another video they think you should watch. And I agree with him. Me and Claude got some work to do. I'm gonna be on the airplane tripping.
I need to know everything. Who and the what and the where. I need everything. Trust me, I hear what you're saying, but I like it's new what you're telling me. I'm curious, George. I hop in the Porsche, a 5 and a horse. I'm ready for war. I'm coming for throats to turn to a ghost. I need to know everything. Now you be surprised at the info you get is by letting them talk, so I'm letting them talk. Gotta keep quiet, maneuver in silence, then let them.